This is one of man's proudest achievements. This complex of buildings, amenities and people. This 20th century city. The mud, filth and ignorance of the Dark Ages is no more. Superstition has been rejected in favour of knowledge. It's the best of all possible worlds, this literate society of ours, this golden age of the printed world. Never before has the ability to read been of such paramount importance. Once, it was the norm for whole sections of society to be illiterate. The ability to read and write was the mark of a privileged member of the upper classes. Today, it could be said that literacy is the birthright of every man, woman and child. In fact, our society makes it a duty to ensure that our children go to school to receive an education. What happens when the child cannot measure up to society's demands for literacy? What happens when the effort of reading assigned is enormous and the thought of reading a book in class is torment? Inevitably, there comes a time when the worried parent seeks advice. And in many cases, this is the beginning of a constructive teacher-parent attempt to tackle the problem. But sometimes, the parent is confronted by rationalizations they instinctively know are not right.
The child is just plain lazy.
The child is a late maturer.
The child just doesn't seem to try.
The child won't pay attention.
What about the child is intelligent, but for some reason can't seem to learn to read and write like the others? Today, attitudes are changing. People are now more aware of the problem, and concerned teachers everywhere are learning to read the signs and refer the child to those people specially trained to help. But for those who slip through the net, too ashamed to seek help, life can be a tragic business. Researchers are worried about the growing volume of statistics which seem to link various types of antisocial behaviour with illiteracy. Case history after case history shows what happens when an individual is quite incapable of conforming to society's accepted standards, one of which is literacy, as in the case of this young girl, barely 22 years old. This girl comes from a good home. Her parents are comfortably off and would do anything to reverse what is happening to their child. But for them, the road will be hard. The time to act is when the child is still young enough to believe everything is possible. A child like Dimity Shaw, 12 years old, smart as a tack, highly strung, headstrong, and quite unable to read or write.
Asking you to stay.
How do you make them?
How should I know? You never know anything.
I thought you wanted a ride home. It's not my fault. How should I know how to make a silly old kite? I could find out. How? They've got books on it in the library.
Great, we can start one today.
It's a mile and a half. They'll be shut by the time we get there.
No, they won't.
What's the big hurry? We can always do it tomorrow.
No, I want to do it now.
All right.
Cross over joystick glued and tightly bound with two or three turns of cord. Don't do it like that.
Says who? It goes bung every time we try it your way. If you just follow the directions, everything would be all right.
Stupid old book. They don't know what they're saying. Look, I think we'd better stop for today. We're just making a mess of things. And whose fault is it? It's cricket tomorrow. I don't want old Jono to keep me in again. And that's what'll happen if I don't get my homework done.
Fancy being scared of old Meathead.
I'm not scared. Anyway, whose fault is it that we're always being kept in?
Not mine.
Listen, don't let's fight. We'll have another go at it. But then, I'll have to get my homework done. Never notch crossover sticks where they join. See, read that bit there.
You've got a pimple coming up.
Billy, I'm sorry. It was only a joke. I didn't mean it, really, I didn't.
All right. But you'll have to pay attention. Cross my heart and hope to die if I don't. See, it's that bit there. That's where we keep going wrong. The book says...
I can read. I don't need you to tell me what the book says.
All right, then. You read it.
Crossover joint should be glued and tightly bound with two or three turns.
Come and get it.
Sorry, Mum. Billy's going upstairs.
Have to get my homework done, Mum.
Oh, 5 minutes won't make any difference. Look at your favourite, chocolate biscuit.
Better not. Dim says I've got a pimple coming up.
Well, if you must, here, take a couple with you. How do you think you'll go tomorrow?
Great. We've got a fantastic fast bowler.
There are many strategies for keeping a secret. Evasion, denial, misleading statements. Dimity Shaw has used them all. But most of all, she has turned her back on the reality of her situation by entering the world of fantasy. At age 12, she is a consummate actress.
Hello.
My mother told me I'm not to speak to strange men.
And quite right too. But see this? That means I'm with the police.
I've never seen a Queensland policeman before.
You've just arrived here, have you? Isn't it a little bit late for you to be out here all by yourself? Now what's up? You can tell me all about it.
Mum told me to wait here. But she hasn't come back yet.
How long ago was that?
School. We came in to buy some new shoes for me. She was going to put me in a taxi home while she went to have a drink with her friends. She left me here while she went to find a parking spot.
Are you sure you didn't go wandering off while she was away and get yourself lost?
No, sir. I've been here all the time.
Well, we can't leave you here, can we? What say we go back to the police station and I'll get one of the lads to drive you home in the police car?
Is the siren going?
We'll have to see about that. What's wrong now?
I can't remember where I live. We've just come up from Sydney. My dad's been up here on a job and he's just sent for us. I've never been in the city before. And I can't remember the name of our street.
Don't you worry your pretty little head about that. That's what we're here for. We'll have you home in a jiffy. Listen, we'll just walk down to the police station now and I'll buy you an ice cream.
A double cone?
You drive a hard bargain. Anyhow, what's your name?
Yes.
Annie. Susie? All right, I give up. What is it?
Timothy. Timothy Mary Shaw.
Ah, and very pretty too.
What's yours?
My name's Constable Moore.
We had a neighbour called Moore once. He drank. My mum used to say he was just great.
Suppose someone tells me what's been going on.
I don't know what to do with her. She won't say one word about it.
Well, Demi, what have you got to say for yourself?
All right, suit yourself. I'll get back to you later. How about something to eat, love?
Oh, I've forgotten all about it. She burnt my finger.
I'm going.
In all the excitement, I forgot all about these. Think you deserve them? Are you feeling any better?
Rob.
Hmm?
What are we going to do about her?
I don't think there's anything we can do.
Oh, you can't be serious. It's obvious there's something terribly wrong. We can't just ignore everything that's been happening.
I'm not suggesting we do.
Oh, don't let's start that again.
Well, do you have a better suggestion?
I'm not having some school psychologist tell me my daughter's crazy.
That's just being silly and you know it. Dimmy needs help and we can't give it. Maybe a specialist can. A teacher seems to think so.
Well, a teacher's just biased. Just because she's highly strung and a little naughty. Oh, don't let's talk about it now, Rob.
Well, promise me at least you'll think about it.
I'll think about it. I promise.
Jimmy, do you want to come and help me plant those seedlings?
I can't. I'm going to paint.
What about doing my portrait?
No, you look awful.
All right, then. But don't get paint all off my flowers.
I won't.
Why don't you come outside in the fresh air for a while, love? To do you good.
Maybe later.
Oh, yes. You're going to let me brave the neighbours all by myself.
They're still being all peculiar.
We're not tourists at the moment. I was thinking of selling my life story to the Sunday papers before it all dies down.
Horrid people. Well, at least we know who our friends are.
What are you watching?
Nothing special. It just helps me relax.
All right. Well, when you've had enough, come on outside.
Learning. Oh, well.
Efficiency goes up with increased motivation. When I say don't bore kids, what I mean is motivate them. Get them interested. get them excited. Now, you've got a child with a learning disability, you've got to figure out where he's at. If he can't write with an ordinary pencil, can he write with a three-edged pencil? If he can't write in the usual lines, can he write in bigger lines? If he can't write when everybody is watching him, can he write if you put him aside in a corner? Can he write if what you ask him to write is simplified? Can he write if he can't do any of those things? Can he write if he uses big wave movements of his arms to get a feeling for what a circle is and what... Where he's at, that's where you start, and you systematically progress from there, giving him lots of repetition, and he won't repeat, he won't practice unless he's motivated.
Wonderful stroke of luck. I'm just so sure they can help us. They weren't at all surprised by the sort of thing she does. I know I'm babbling, aren't I?
Look, why don't you tell me all about it right from the beginning?
I'm so glad they had an after-hours number. I couldn't have waited till Monday. Well, this man on television was talking about children who can't learn to read or write. Well, he told us about an organisation called Spells. So I rang up and talked to Mrs. Marsh. She's a psychiatrist. I'm taking Dimity in to see her on Monday. Dimity?
There's no need to worry about Dimmy. She's probably off somewhere creating another masterpiece.
Well, at least it'll keep her out of mischief. Well, we arranged to take her in on Monday afternoon. She's going to do some sort of test or something, and then she said that she and I could work together, you know, to teach her how to read.
Do have some. I'm not supposed to eat them.
No, thanks.
Well, maybe later.
I didn't want to come. She made me.
I'm sure you didn't. I remember when I was a child, my mother was always making me do things I didn't want to do. Most annoying.
There's nothing wrong with me. And anyway, what would you know? You don't even have a proper office.
You're right, I don't. But then I find offices such unfriendly places. I've always preferred to work from home. Now then, let's see what we've got here. Your mother brought these for me to have a look at. She's very proud of you. I can't say I'm surprised. You do have a marvellous feeling for colour. I'm most impressed.
They're mine. She had no right.
Oh, blame it on me, dear. I asked to see them. Well, I'm mad about art, but I can't draw a straight line myself. So I console myself with looking at things other people do. I think yours are very good.
I think I will have a cake.
Help yourself. Eat them all, and I can't be tempted. Here, have a look at this. Matisse. Marvellous man with colour. And quite a rebel. You should study him.
What's a rebel?
Someone who won't compromise their ideas for others. Someone who tries to be themselves. Well, at least that's my definition. I'm using too many big words, aren't I? Fascinating things, words, if you know how to use them properly.
He's weird, but I like him. Wish it were mine.
Oh, you should go to the library.
I don't belong to a library. They're silly.
I'll give this book to your mother for you to have a look at. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Have a look at this for a moment. Took me ages to do it. Let's see what you can do with it. Put your finger on a dog. And another dog. And another one. Good. Now, have a look at the picture and see if you can tell me how many dogs there are hidden in the picture. Come on.
One.
Yes.
Two.
That's right.
Three.
Oh, goodness, I missed that one.
4.
Yes.
5.
You see any more?
6. Oh. 7.
Yes.
8.
Mm-hmm.
9. 10. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. I like the seaside best. Last time we went, Dad hired a boat and we went way out. He didn't catch anything, and boy, was he mad.
Poor old Dad. Well, I think that's about it. Didn't he? Quite a long face, and he wanted to think I was a monster.
I suppose you want to see her now.
Yes, I do want to see you, Mother, but first I want to tell you what I've found out.
Me?
Certainly. Come over here beside me. Your mother brought you to me because she's worried about you. Your reports from school.
They say I can't read or write. But I can. I can. Kids say I'm a dill. I'm not.
Of course you're not. You're a very intelligent and talented girl, Dimity. And I can understand how it must feel seeing other children having no trouble at all with reading and writing. It doesn't seem fair, does it?
No!
There is something you can do about it, you know. I'm going to write a letter to a friend of mine. She's specially trained to help people who have your problem with learning to read and write. Now, it'll mean a lot of hard work on your part. But if you try, I'm sure she'll be able to help you.
I don't mind hard work.
Of course you don't. Now, here's what we'll do. Right. Off you go now and send your mother in, will you?
Okay. I'm glad I came.
I'll come straight to the point, Mrs. Shaw. I believe your daughter has a learning disability. The most obvious symptoms of which are her inability to acquire the basic skills like reading and writing. The behaviour problems, tantrums, fantasising, inability to concentrate for any length of time. All of these things are, in my opinion, directly connected with and the result of the pressures she has to live with every day.
But Dimity picks up things just like that. Oh, I'll admit she has a problem with her writing. Well, that's why I came here.
Your daughter, Mrs. Shaw, like so many other kids with a learning disability, is certainly above average in intelligence. But you see, intelligence wears many faces. After all, you're an intelligent woman. But I'm sure there are some things you're very good at and others which give you difficulty. Isn't that so? And the same thing applies with Dimity. Let me show you something. What do you see?
An N and an M.
And which comes first?
The N, of course.
Now, that's my point. For you, there's not the slightest doubt. But Dimity and other children like her just can't make that kind of fine distinction which shows us the difference in shape. Now, getting the order of the letters mixed up is another thing. Now, here, she means to copy the word church, but she writes C-H-R-U-T-H.
Well, all right, she's got a writing difficulty, but she can read. Well, I've heard her homework myself from time to time. There's absolutely nothing wrong with her reading.
Yes, Mrs. Shaw, I can understand how you'd feel that. You see, from the tests I gave Dimity this morning, it's obvious that she has a very good memory for things she's heard. And you see, if she's in a little group at school for oral reading, then she's heard the story read so many times before that by now she knows it off by heart.
Well, I'll accept that for the moment. But if she is so clever at fooling everybody, why the tantrums? And I still can't see any justification for those awful lies she tells.
Well, you call it a lie. I call it a fantasy. And the difference being that a fantasy is a means of escaping from reality. So much so that she ends up believing her stories herself.
Just hair-splitting.
Yes, you could see it that way. But you see, Mrs. Shaw, Dimity's really very unhappy about her inability to cope. You can't blame her for using her lively imagination to compensate. The worst thing about all this is that her problem can only be understood by a trained observer. Let's just imagine for a moment that that Dimity had lost an arm or a leg, that she had some physical disability. Well, then we'd know how to treat her, wouldn't we? We'd realise that certain situations would be impossible for her. We wouldn't expect her to do things like trying to play basketball or hopscotch. It would be very cruel, wouldn't it?
Of course it would.
Well, if you think about it for a moment, that's precisely what's happening to her. She has to go to school. She has no option. Day after day. And every day she finds herself caught in a situation where she must fail. Now, these sorts of pressures on any small child must inevitably result in what most people would call bad behaviour. But there has to be some release. You must see that.
Oh, I had no idea. Oh, I've been so dense and selfish. Well, you see, her teachers have talked about it to me before. They said there was something wrong. It was suggested ages ago that I should take her to the school psychologist, and I wouldn't. Well, I thought that everybody would find out and that people who knew us would be talking about us behind our backs. But if I'd known what the problem really was...
I know. But it must be dealt with or it becomes worse. At least you did act when you realised that Speld might be able to get some help for Dimity. Oh, if we could only get all these children at Dimity's age, we'd be able to prevent a great deal of unhappiness. So many of them grow up and go through life trying to hide the fact that they can't read a street sign, or that they can't write well enough to fill out a job application. And of course, in our society, that's just not acceptable. In the old days, they could get away with it, but not anymore.
So what happens now? Can she be taught to read and write?
There are remedial teachers who can help a great deal. And I'm referring Dimity to a teacher who's had great success in this field. Well, it may be that Dimity will never be a champion at reading and writing. But if she and the remedial teacher both work hard, I think you'll find that not only will her performance in the basic skills improve at school, but she'll be a much happier little girl, particularly now that she understands the problem too.
You've no idea what a relief this is. It seems much better once you know the truth. I suppose all parents say that.
That's quite a natural reaction, Mrs. Shaw. Now, I'll send a copy of my report and recommendations to the school, and I think you'll find that they'll do everything they can to help.
Thank you, Mrs. Marsh.
Oh, it's been a great pleasure. By the way, I promised her this. She liked it so much, I said I'd lend it to her.
Oh, it's beautiful. She's so keen on art.
And she's very good at it. So remember, praise her strengths. And this is one of them. Oh, that's Dimity and Smooger, my dog. He's like me, never gets enough exercise.
It's a happy sound, isn't it? A child laughing.
Yes, it is. It's very nice.